Hey there, thanks for checking out my video. This is Adam with the Cloud Automation Blog. In this video, I'm going to be going over ServiceNow orchestration. What we're looking at right now is a ServiceNow orchestration canvas. So it's very straightforward. As you can see, there's a begin, a run script, and an end. In this video, this is the last of the four orchestration engines that I've reviewed. Feel free to check out the other ones. So before I jump in text explaining this workflow, I just want to set some context around this run script. So ServiceNow has an HTTP REST message or an HTTP REST method for making HTTP REST API calls, which I found a little confusing. So I am not actually using that. What I'm using is a scriptable task. So you can see here the run script. So I'll drill into this real quick just to set some context so you understand as we walk through this what's actually going on. So this is the actual REST call right here. So it's the getWeather.getWeather by zip. So just remember that just for 1 second. getWeather.getWeather by zip, and then there's a variable being passed into that. So if I go over here to something called it's a script include. So I'll actually click that so you can follow through. So you want to go to orchestration/script include. I'm going to type in the name of my script include and hit enter. I'm going to drill down into it and let the code load there. So we can see here the getWeather is the name of the class. And the getWeather by zip is the function, and we're passing in the zip code. So we can see here we're creating a new REST message. There's the API key, which actually I can comment that out because that was for a previous version that I was working on. You can actually see it's down here as well. The endpoint, which is the API endpoint, the method we're doing, which is get. So the verb, again, there's get, delete, post, put, there's a bunch of them. For this, we're getting the information from the REST endpoint. We're passing the zip code and getting information back. And then the actual query parameter. So the zip code, the units, and the app ID. And then we're doing some logging below. So that should make a little bit more sense now if I jump back to the actual orchestration workflow canvas. You can see here what we're doing is we're actually executing that REST API call and we're passing the variable workflow.variables.u_zip_code. So again, let's remember that for just 1 second. That's the user input. So how do we actually get that name? So if I click the hamburger in the top left here and I go to edit inputs, we can see there's a zip code. So if I click zip code, you'll see the column name is u_zip_code. So that is the actual name of the variable that we would use to reference throughout this workflow. If you had multiple variables, they would all start with the workflow.variables, and you just put another period next, and then the actual name of the column name or the variable name to pull that data. So one thing that's really nice about ServiceNow, as well as some of the other orchestration engines, is they're all JavaScript. What we're looking at here and what we're looking at in the script include is all JavaScript. So because it's used so widely, there is a wealth of information on something like CodePlex or on SourceForge, across the internet really, there is a ton of JavaScript and how you could use it to orchestrate process. So this is a pretty straightforward workflow. Once you actually get the REST API call done, and then you can execute that call via a run script task, which is found over here on the right. If you go to core and then type in script, filter them down, you'll see there run script. So you just want to drag that onto the canvas and then modify it however you want it. Give it a name, assign it a stage if needed, and then paste the code that you actually wanted to execute within that script. So now all we have to do is actually debug this workflow. So if we click play over here, this little play button, it says start, but it's pretty much a debug button. It's going to launch the workflow, and as requested, we have to enter that zip code, and it's required. So I'm going to enter a zip code. Click start, and what we're looking for is blue. So we should see blue. So we do, that means everything succeeded. But unfortunately, the actual output, the debug output, anything that we needed is not displayed here. What we need to do is go back to ServiceNow, go to all workflow contexts, and you can see this most recent workflow context I just executed. I can click this context, and that's where it actually provides the information to me. So if I go to workflow logs, you can see here the response body. Is everything right here, everything we needed. So I hope that helped. I'll have more videos coming around REST API calls and orchestration within the ServiceNow platform. Like my video, subscribe. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.